Hi, my name's Josie, and I'm here with two of my colleagues, Teresa and Dorothy, and we're talking about how adult children will initiate a conversation with their parent about either care in the home or perhaps even moving into long-term care. So, Teresa, when is the right time to start the conversation?
Josie, the right time to start a conversation about care needs is before there's ever a crisis. So a good rule of thumb is the 40-70 rule, and that is if you're a child, you're 40 years of age, and you have a parent who's 70, then start having those conversations. Unfortunately, though, more often than not is the case that these discussions take place when there's some sort of a crisis happening.
What kind of care is available in the communities to support our parents?
Well, there are many options available to family members that they should consider. The first is home care, where the family member can stay in the home and services provided in their own environment. Secondly, they can look at supportive housing. Again, the family member can live independently, but also get the support that they need within the home. There is retirement living, again, and then finally, if those care needs cannot be met by any of those settings, they may consider a long-term care setting.
Teresa, if we went into our parents' home, how would we know that something was amiss, something was different in what was happening in the home that would trigger us to have a conversation with our parent?
Josie, there's about four things that adult children should look for. If their parent has had repeated admissions to the emergency department, that's a good trigger that something's not working at home. Safety is another huge issue. If a child is going home and finding that mum's leaving a kettle on, or if she's finding that mum's having difficulty keeping dad in the house at nighttime because he's exit seeking or through the day, then it's time to give some consideration to other options. Another issue of concern for children and also for caregivers is incontinence. When the person that is being cared for becomes incontinent, it is difficult for people. And lastly is, if you're a caregiver in the community, sometimes they too are socially isolated. It's a difficult job to be doing all on your own, and sometimes that's a trigger for kids to sit down with their mom and dad and have a heart-to-heart discussion.
We need information. This is an important decision for families to consider because they do want to do what's best for their loved one. Dorothy, can you share with us what kinds of information might be available to assist a family in making this decision?
Well, they should contact their local community care access centers. They can find the numbers in the phone book. Secondly, there is a number they can call, 211. Which provides additional information for them. And finally, they can go on the Ministry of Health and Long-Term Care website, which lists all of the long-term care facilities in Ontario, and more importantly, how those facilities fare against Ministry of Health standards.
Thank you so much for joining us. We hope that we have shared with you some answers to some important questions that you might be facing in helping your parents through their journey.